Good morning, everyone. Thanks for joining us from your homes, wherever you may be. And if you're physically able to, why don't you reach out your arms right now and then just reach them way up high over your head and just stretch those hands out and wiggle those fingers and just open yourself to the good that is yours today from God. Welcome it in joyfully. And then just settle into your space and join us with this gathering music, please.
Sweet dreams. and I feel that sweet release. I start my day with love. I start my day with peace. I start my day with joy, and I feel that sweet release. I start my day with love. I start my day with peace. I start my day with joy, and I feel that sweet release. I start my day with love. I start my day with peace. I start my day with joy, and I feel that sweet release. I start my day with love. I start my day with peace. I start my day with joy, and I feel that sweet release. Day with love. I start my day with peace. I start my day with joy, and I feel that sweet release. Love, love, love.
It's everywhere. Yes, we start our day with love. Ah, I'm just going to take a breath. Ah. Welcome to Unity San Diego. I'm Reverend Edith Washington Woods, the senior minister here, and I'd like to welcome all of you here on this day. And if you'll just take a moment to pray with me for a minute. And we pray, God, the good, omniscience, everywhere presence, we give great thanks for this day, for we get to demonstrate love today, that we have the opportunity to spread love in our lives. May we each contemplate what love looks like in this time we get to share together. In this moment we pray, and so it is. And if you'd say our love offering affirmation, say our affirmation with me together. Guided by infinite wisdom and prospered by divine love, we go forward in unity to realize our spiritual potential. And I'd like to welcome all of you here who are out there in love streaming land. Hello from wherever you are in this great country and beyond. Thank you for being with us and welcome to our spiritual community. And now we have our vision statement. Our vision is who we are bigger, like globally, what we really are seeking to express into the world. If you can say our vision statement with me together, we are a world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. Wouldn't that be wonderful? And then we have our mission statement, which is who we are as Unity San Diego. And perhaps even if you're not, you know, considering yourself a member or someone who comes here a lot or a little, perhaps you can align with our vision statement with us. We are empowering personal growth through positive spiritual principles, inspirational music, and community service. And right now, we're giving our service at staying home, staying safe. And for those of us in California and some places and throughout this country, we cover our nose and our mouths. So our opening hymn is, well, song is, Love is My Decision.
No one else can tell.
Is our decision. It is. And now it's time to greet your neighbor. And for those of you online live streaming right now, I'd like you to put into the chat box, I am willing to spread love to you. I am willing to spread love to you. That way we're greeting each other. And we're going to do it over here.
I am willing to spread love to you.
I am willing to spread love, my love, to you. I am willing to spread my love to you. Now, this morning, our beautiful flowers here on the altar are from Butch and Kathy Davis, our very Kathy over there, with love and honor of their 45th wedding anniversary.
Wow. And we're still friends.
And they're still friends, and they're still living together throughout this corona thing. Here are our announcements for today. Every day on Facebook Live, we have a daily prayer and meditation at 9 a.m. that either Reverend Carla or myself will do. Now, I'll be going on vacation in a few days, and there'll be a plethora of people praying during the time that I'm on vacation. I hope I'm going on a cruise. I don't think that's happening. But anyway, we also have the Q process that is going to be happening next Saturday on April 25th via Zoom with Reverend Carla. If you're interested in taking this class, please contact her so you can get registered. And now this is the conclusion of our announcements for today. And I'd like you to sit back, relax, and listen to our meditation song, I Am Love. We are love. We are love. In this now moment, I invite you to gently close your eyes and relax into this moment, bringing our attention to the activity of love's presence. For we are love. And in this present moment, I would like to have you consider a heart, a pink heart, and imagine that you're holding this pink heart in your hand. Imagine what it feels like, the texture of the cloth that has become a pink heart. How does it feel? Touching it with your fingertips, allowing it to become one with you and you with it. Perhaps it feels soft. Perhaps it is feeling like it needs to be loved by you and only you. So in this moment, as we know for sure that we are love, we bring our love into this heart-shaped beingness. We allow ourselves to expand our heart space, our heart chakra, and know that we are expanding it to this heart-shaped, this experience, this beingness of love. And imagine that you're drawing it in, into your chest, and feeling that experience of love even more. Oh, how good it feels to be loved and to give love, to spread love. And imagine for a moment that you're holding this country that this symbol of heart-shaped love is, the love that we give to this country and everyone in it. for it's up to us to spread our love to all of us. Only love. And imagine that it's bigger than our country, that it's the entire planet. That in this feeling we're experiencing of love's presence, that this heart-shaped love object is the world. And we have the opportunity to spread our love to the world. We take this experience into a time of silence where we get to deepen our conscious contact with God, the good, omniscience, everywhere presence. We take a pause and experience love now. I am love. I am spreading love. I am spreading love to an entire planet. For it's up to me. And in this expanded state of awareness, we bring into our hearts all, like everyone and everything. And we include ourselves in this, for we are all one. In this moment, we know it to be true. And then we gently bring ourselves back to this space and time. We understand that we have the ability to spread love everywhere. And it's up to us. In this moment we pray, and so it is. Amen. And now, if you'll say with me the Lord's Prayer, together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. And now we have Love Will Come Around.
Good morning. Both of the songs we have for you deal with the fundamental truth of what love really is. And this first one by Greg Tamblyn and Lance Cowan is about that divine paradox of love that you have to give it away to receive it. The good news is that we each have the power to do this, to put love out there, to set it in motion so that love will come around.
You built that wall high enough by now. Something that I might fall and hurt you when it comes down. Oh, it won't ease your pain-filled heart, building a wall to keep you apart. Give a little love when there's no
trusting that you believe that love will come around, that it always comes around. As many of you know, we celebrated Easter last week. And one of the things that normally happens on Easter is the Easter egg hunt. I'm guessing that many children and families whom did not have the opportunity to do this, to have an Easter egg hunt, maybe were sad. But I'm wondering, why is it that people attend these hunts to find an Easter egg every year? Why do people color boiled eggs every year, year after year? I heard that even here at Unity San Diego, that people from around our community, that they stuff or even dye over 500 eggs every year. And those 500 eggs get hidden all over our campus for the little children. But why do people do this? I think that one of the reasons why many of us boil or stuff plastic eggs is because we really want to be able to spread love. That those children that are picking up the eggs and running around and looking in bushes and underneath rocks, they have no idea the love that was poured into the preparation of those eggs. Wow. So that didn't happen, at least not here at Unity San Diego this year. But one of the things that is happening around this great country, and perhaps even, yes, definitely throughout the world, is people keep showing up. Their imaginations are kind of running wild with nothing else to do. So there was a mother in Atlanta. She had this grand idea to have a virtual Easter egg hunt. So what she posted was for people in their neighborhood and the surrounding area near Atlanta where they lived to create eggs and put them on their door. And here are some examples. They're really cute. People came up with all sorts of beautiful looking eggs and just put them on their doors. And they were told to put them on their doors, but some people put them on their windows. Some people put them on the house. And the next, what she said for them to do after was that people would walk down the streets or drive in their cars and count how many eggs they could come up with. And the winner would get some prize or something. The winner would win. That's basically what would happen. So can you imagine? All these little kids, and some of them, put on their best Easter bonnets. Well, some people also dressed up as Easter bunnies and all sorts of characters as they walked or drove in cars, counting the number of eggs. Yeah. It's a wonderful thing when we use our imagination, isn't it? Well, Carl Jung, he stated, your vision will become clear only when you can look inside your heart. Who looks outside dreams, who looks inside awakens. So I'm guessing with all the things we don't get to do, that our imagination allows us to look inside. We look inside in a way that probably wouldn't happen if we were running around doing the things we were doing before we needed to stay home. That so much imagination is happening because we're not able to look on the outer, like, what can I do? Where can I drive to? What beach can I go to? You know, all of the things we typically do, that right now we're on a little pause. And the imagination that gets to come up, and by the way, next month is, no, it's not, it's June. June is imagination. But just the same, us being able to use our imagination faculty to come up with these wonderful, wonderful ideas. Now, our co-founder, Charles Fillmore, he talks about love a lot throughout his books and various publications that he had. And this particular one is the definition of love, which is in The Revealing Word, a book of metaphysical terms. And for those of you who don't know what metaphysical is, metaphysical is beyond the physical, beyond what we can see. And he says, love is an inner quality that sees good everywhere and in everybody. It insists that all is good, and by refusing to see anything but good, it causes that quality finally to appear uppermost in itself and in all things. You see, love is, it's always right here. If you just point to yourself for a moment, love is always right here. And it has the opportunity to radiate out from us if we're willing to allow it, as Charles Fillmore says, to just be everywhere. And that when we refuse to see anything else but love, then love shows up. So, here we are. Another day, another week, another month to stay home. And I look at people around the world, and I look at the number of people who have been impacted by this COVID-19. There's no one that's not. Not even the plants and the animals and the fishes in the deep blue sea. We all are impacted by it. But how do we choose to see it? If we look at it through the eyes of love, then we can pour our love out to all of those who are directly in it. Like all of the healthcare workers, people at grocery stores, meat packing processing plants, like everywhere. How can I take that love that is within me, and I'm speaking these words for you, and allow it to be out there in the world? It's an energy, it's a vibration that we get to live into. Now, the opposite, well, you know what the opposite is. There's either love or there's hate. So who are we gonna hate on now? I'm not even gonna suggest it. But I'm guessing that people hate on other people or other things just because. We wanna go back to our old way of living. I get it. I don't want to wear this bandana on Sunday and when I stop talking, make sure my everything is covered up. But this is what our county in San Diego says. In order for us to come and provide a service for you, When we're not talking or singing, we must cover our nose and our mouth. So I found a pinkish scarf. It fits with the color of the month. I don't know if I have, next month it's purple. Do I have a purple scarf? I'm not thinking about next month. I'm thinking about today. So if we have those times when we hate on someone, I know I'm softening it up a little bit, then perhaps we're called to shift it to love. Not like I love you and I want to give you a hug, because we can't hug anyways, but just the vibration of love. Now our Bible verse for today, so here is another way that people have shown and demonstrated love, and it is a whole bunch of hearts. I don't know if you can see that. And right in the middle of the hearts, it says, love each other. That's what we're talking about. Love each other. Now, you don't need to fit into society or reform in order to make an impact. Just like the lady in Atlanta. Be you, spread love, raise your own vibration, because that's what's important. To shift our vibration to love, expressing love. And here's our Bible verse. It comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 14, and it states, let all that you do be done in love. I'm going to say that again. That's kind of juicy. Juicy few little words. Let all that you do be done in love. Seems like a simple thing, doesn't it? I don't know. Now, Eric Butterworth, one of our Unity authors, he said, we cannot be whole without love. So imagine you have a pie, like a lemon meringue pie. Yeah. And you want to take a slice of the pie, but is the slice of pie any different than the whole pie? Yeah, I get it. It's less calories and all of the other stuff and whatever. But if you think about it, I'm thinking about a lemon meringue pie. It's got the meringue on the top and that yummy yellow filling and a crust. All of it was made at one time in the mind. You see, the mind said, hey, I think it'll be a good idea to make a lemon meringue pie. Now, it may be someone making it at home or someone making it at a bakery or a restaurant or something like that. But the whole of it demonstrates love. The slice of it is a part of that whole. So if we can imagine that we cannot be whole without love. Love is always, always there. And Mother Teresa said this, spread love everywhere you go. Let no one ever come to you without leaving happier. Yeah. So I'll go back to the Easter egg hunt and the cars specifically. You know, people are doing things in cars nowadays that you wouldn't even, well, I would have never thought it was possible or even a thought. Like a little girl who turned 10 that couldn't have a party, but her mother's created her a space for a party. And a bunch of their friends came by with signs on their car doors and whatever, happy birthday, happy 10th birthday. And the little girl was out there jumping up and down like she was a kangaroo. And she was elated by all these people. Many of them did not even know her. One person was even playing a trumpet. Yeah. In the carload full of people with nothing else to do but give a 10-year-old happiness. So I ask you this question as we start to bring this to a close. What can you do to spread love? What can you do to spread love? I invite you to place an answer in the chat box. And those of you who watch it later, just answer the question. What can you do to spread love? We can spread love in 1 minute, in 1 nanosecond, by allowing the vibration of love to move from inside to outside of us, thinking loving thoughts. And if we have that energy and vibration of hating on someone for whatever they said, did, or might do, we can shift it to the experience and activity of love. The oceans depend on it. The rivers and streams depend on it. Every person, every plant, every animal, everything in this world depends on us shifting our vibration to love. And our affirmation can assist us throughout the week. Here we go. I am spreading love to every person on this planet with who I am being. If you'll say that with me, please. I am spreading love to every person on this planet with who I am being. Again, I am spreading love to every person on this planet with who I am being. So let's just take that for a moment into the silence. Because who are we? We are individualized expressions of God. We are love. I am love. That is who we are being. Let's breathe into that. And if you'll open your eyes, if you have them closed like I do, and let's say this affirmation one more time, because our planet depends on us. Together, I am spreading love to every person on this planet with who I am being. And so it is. And so we let it be. Amen. And now we have our song ready to receive the love of God.
5, 6, 7.
Ready to receive the love of God.
No, you're ready.
Ready to receive the love of God.
Are you ready to receive the love of God? Yes. And so with us receiving also comes giving. We have a basket here. There are some tithes and love offerings in them. And we also have a donate button. Not on Facebook at the moment, but if you were to go to www.unitysandiego.org, you can donate on the donate button, which is through PayPal. But you also can not do PayPal, and it gives you an opportunity to put in your credit card information or your debit card. So it's not only PayPal. You can also send in a check. And Reverend Carla is typing all that stuff into the chat box of our address and whatnot. And we give thanks for all of those who have donated in the past several weeks when we're all online. You could also give by automatic giving through your banking institution. And I want you to also know that there are prayer opportunities here at Unity San Diego, which includes our prayer workers who have new hours from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday. One of them may be placing that information in the chat box with the phone number. And also we have prayer chaplains. Our prayer chaplains normally are here in the sanctuary, but right now they're out there with you guys watching the live streaming and holding sacred space. Okay, so we have our love offering blessing, and I'm going to say it twice and then ask you to read it to yourself or say it to yourself. And here we go. I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. Again, I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. And now say it to yourself. And we pray. Spirit, infinite presence, we know that there is all good, for there is only God. May each of us be open and receptive to just give, to give in the manner, in the same manner that it took us to come and give in the manner we're giving now. The hundreds of people who view us live stream, for those of us who are giving service here today for you, and just knowing that giving, as we give, it comes back tenfold. We pray this in the name and through the nature of the Christ presence within us, and so it is. Amen.
The next song is by Fred Bogert. It's a children's song that I first learned from this book that was given to me probably about 25 years ago by the youth ed minister here at the time. That's Marianne Lemieux. And I was new to Unity, so I found this book and these songs really very helpful in understanding Unity principles, internalizing them, and learning the truth, for example, about growing love.
One, two, three, and.
It's a seed that we can sow. With our caring, it will grow. We are family, we are friends, and the feeling never ends. Together we're forever growing love. We seek the sunshine, we bless the rain. Through the storms we know the sun will shine again. Illumined from
that we can sow with our caring, it will grow. We are family, we are friends, and the feeling never ends. Together we're forever growing love.
We take a moment to bless these tithes and love offerings, and just want to read to you what Mahatma Gandhi said. He said, "Where there is love, there is life." Yeah. So we bless these tithes, love offerings, and gifts. We bless the giver. We bless all of us, knowing that there is an abundance of all we need and want. Even if it appears differently, we claim abundance right now. We proclaim prosperity consciousness right now in our hearts. We know it to be true, and so it is. Amen. We also want to pray over our prayer box, knowing that all prayers that are given, put in our box or in our inboxes on the online, or calling our prayer ministry, or any of the prayers that are done worldwide, we're praying with and for them now. We pray. We pray that the good is showing up. We know that it is. We see it demonstrated in so many ways, that there is a mass demonstration of good in this world and love in this world. We give thanks for this awareness, this prayer consciousness, and we know that it is up to us. In this moment we pray, and so it is. Amen. And now I invite you to sing along with our closing song, More Than Enough.
There is more than enough in the universe that you created. There is more than enough on a planet of sacred design. Humanity made in your image.
for protection together. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. And namaste. Have a wonderful week.